Isn't there something truly magical about a sunrise? It happens each day, yet every morning it takes my breath away. One of the most magnificent sights of nature, it brings positivity and excitement into my life and its moments, filling me with hope and promise of a new beginning, day after day, every day.
But amidst all the life and its magical moments, can something as simple as watching a sunrise be a pursuit in itself?
Not necessarily a pursuit, you're going to watch it from the window of your house, but certainly one. If you have plans to watch the sunrise, like we do.
Our journey begins here, at the verdant tea states of Assam. We are on a 400 kilometers drive, starting from Assam through Arunachal Pradesh onto the easternmost tip of our country to see the first sunrise of India at Dong Valley.
Now all of this is fine, but we must first cross this bridge.
Not just any other bridge, it's the iconic Dhola Sadia Bridge. And I'm going to take you to a spot which lets you see the bridge in its full scale and glory.
Now, how's that for a view?
Amazing. Internet says that there are 182 of these piers and the whole contraption is earthquake proof. This is a 9.15 kilometer long bridge, making it India's longest.
9.15 is like 4 kilometers longer than the Bandra Valley Sea Link.
Yes, yes, yes.
Come, let's go. Velong is a long way.
Velong is a long, long way.
Arunachal, here we come. As we move into Arunachal Pradesh, the road's quite good because I was expecting unpaved roads.
Roads do get worse, but the destinations are totally worth it.
And just like that, we had reached the banks of the river, where we took our first pit stop for the journey. Parshuram Koil.
What an amazing evening to end the day with, no?
Yeah.
And place is stunningly beautiful, yet so disconnected.
The sun went down at 4 p.m. I mean, I was struggling for exposure at 4:30 in the evening.
And Arjun, to think of it, we're only halfway done through our journey.
And just when you thought, the experience fizzles out at night.
Yeah.
Look above.
Multitudes of glittering stars.
Dawn began day two of our journey, the drive to Velong. It seemed that the river was never going to leave our sight, and the mountains, they kept getting bigger.
I was wondering all the time with those pristine roads back then and I couldn't believe myself as to how are the roads so good when you're traveling to such a remote location of the country.
And remember, the mountains were just a visual hint for us and now we are a part of the mountains.
By the way, have you noticed we are driving through the mountains as if we were the river itself?
Yeah, well, actually, the river Lohit leads us directly to Velong.
5 hours since we have been on the road.
5 more hours to go.
So Arjun, Valong was a long way away, but we're finally here. And that, I feel, that there is going to be where the sun rises, Dong Valley.
Well, actually, it's bit to the right.
That's Dong Valley.
So tomorrow when we see the sun, or let me put it this way, you have short sunrises in Peru, Bolivia, Antarctica.
Well, different sunrises in different places mean different things to me. But let me ask you a question. What does tomorrow's sunrise mean to you?
Too deep a question for this hour. I think we should just go get some rest. The trek begins in a few hours. It's going to be quite something.
I hope we get lucky with the weather, man. Seems quite cloudy right now.
Could possibly rain.
At 1 a.m., it began. An 8-kilometer long trek.
A brisk climb up the mountain that would roughly take us 3 hours if it were to rain. But it didn't. With nothing but just a beautiful dawn in our way, we had reached the top of the mountain.
Oh man, what do you think?
I'm speechless.
And while there may be sunrises aplenty, this was special. Because this is where light first breaks in India. Near a humble village at the edge of the country, in a valley called Dong. And thus, we had seen the first sunrise of India at Dong Valley, where light breaks out first upon a billion dreams.